two things I think that people have a blinders on that leave us vulnerable to them. One is inflation. And secondly, as you say, with the Fed's pivot, here we are with the stock market making new highs, and people are revising down their corporate earnings outlook. So I'm concerned that in my work, what I sort of see, I know that the common urban legend, if you will, and the Federal Reserve fosters it, people like Janet Yellen saying the Fed is a murderer, the Fed kills business cycles. But in my career, it's not the case. The great financial crisis wasn't caused by too tight a Fed policy. The tech bubble wasn't caused by too tight a Fed policy. The savings and loan crisis, those are the last three economic downturns. That to me, it leaves us vulnerable to what really hurts us, and that's financial instability.
And in your opinion, what would cause that financial instability? Because we do know, Mark, there is a large amount of debt issuance. We look at the corporate bond market, one-third is junk, one-third is triple B, and maybe one-third is quality. So if the economy was to weaken and credit spreads widen, and let's say a lot of this short-term debt doesn't get rolled over, could that be the epicenter of financial instability? In other words, if we were to have financial instability, where would it come out of?
It's like what you have in California, where you have a drought and it doesn't rain for a long time. You know that you're vulnerable to a fire, but you're just not sure what's going to be the spark, where is it going to be? And I think in some ways it's true about the financial condition to get to this kind of point where they think the Federal Reserve is on hold, the Federal Reserve is dovish. White House is still calling for a 50 basis point interest rate cut, a resumption of QE. And so, when early in my career, I remember when Gorbachev came to New York and he got out of his car and he shook people's hands. With that like gesture, stock markets turned around. It was like the bottom of the stock market. And it might have been after the 87 crash. I just sort of marvel at, like yourself, I'm always thinking about these kind of things, like what's going to be the spark? What's going to be the, where's the vulnerabilities? And I think there's so many different places they could be. People are positioned in big ways in the treasury market, currencies, a lot of leverage. I think that's really the takeaway, is that ultimately it's not a bad decision or a bad investment that causes the crisis, but it's too much risk in the system. And this is where I think that Minsky comes in, is just that financial stability itself leads to instability. Stocks only go up, well, let's borrow more money, let's put more money into the stock market.